in the mirror. ABC's winning the mirror.
But that was a month ago at the spring final. Yeah. I mean, maybe they found out some crazy strategy, but honestly, it looked like they were getting ran over in the previous series. We're going to see if they've done some adaptations here in game number one.
Well, I mean, look at their name. Change my mind. They're going to have to change their mind because we all think that this is not a good pick coming in from them. I mean, maybe they feel like if they get enough reps in this matchup that it is a favorite matchup, and maybe they're right. But so far, I'm unconvinced. If they lose game number one, it's not going to go well in the series.
Interesting. They were attacking in Poike at the start of the match and then kind of just gave up on it immediately. And now both rogues are just going at each other. Waz looking like he wants to be dancing around onto a different target as soon as possible. And that is some of the surprise that Method Black bring on their Rogue Mage Druid, is that they will just attack anything at any moment. And if you're not ready and prepared for it, then you could simply lose at the start of the match. Delay the target, but Chaz is crowd controlled. Waz is the one in trouble. Chaz knows this, denies it entirely with the Iron Bark activated to reduce the damage and prevent the kill. Waz will begin to stabilize and then continue in attack, actually getting cycloned up, looking like they're trying to slow down the ramp. Neither team really blowing any significant amount of cooldowns. Only the Icy Veins for Raikou and Shadow Fiend of Valet. Vendettas are available, so the rogues are the most threatening player in the game at this moment in time. Which rogue is going to get the setups? We've seen some flashy plays from Acro. He's had a lot of games to warm up on at this point. Perhaps that could be part of the reason that Change My Mind find victory here, whereas Method Black, unless they were queuing in some war games or on the ladder in between, they might be not as warmed up. Waz behind the corner, but activated Faint before this stun. It may not actually be enough. Very low on health. Multiple Gladiator's Maledicts. Chaz is comfortable despite Waz being so low on health. Connecting some heals, looking for a clone, but gets cloned himself. Well done by Minpoike. Acro setting up potentially for the win here if they can stay on target. Waz has cooldowns, now finally trading evasion. Ducking for cover to avoid the Vendetta pressure of Acro. Waz now has Vendetta of his own to lead the charge, and really curious where he decides to allocate that, because right now there's no real target that's too great. Looks like they're going to go after Acro. They're dropping the smoke bomb. They're baiting Acro. Actually, now they waited until the last second of the stun to commit the Vendetta and then trying to make Acro choke, but Acro did not choke in that position. Trades out the cooldowns, but even making the trade is very far behind.
Yeah, evasion, Cloak of Shadows, Trinket no longer available. Waz, on the other hand, he still has his Trinket and Cloak of Shadows. He should be A-okay. Raikou still generating some pressure for his team. Chaz goes into the bash. Waz now is the one that's vulnerable. He reverses the pressure onto Acro. Kleptomania spell steal coming in from Raikou. Acro is going to be completely clean of those heal over time effects. Minpoike is going to have to play a little bit of catch up in this matchup. And you can see his mana is getting taxed. This is what we saw in the upper bracket finals between these two teams. It's a similar story where Method Black, they had a lot of control of the matchup. They even had the mana lead. Luckily, Minpoike's been doing a pretty good job in this matchup so far, holding onto his mana. You can see Innervate basically even for both of these healers as well. If Chaz can ever go sit away for a drink, it's going to be really scary for Change My Mind.
I will say that they're not attacking Valet nearly as much in this matchup. Method Black have switched their strategies, all of their focus on Acro. They're not really bouncing between targets. Waz mind controlled, but Chaz is drinking. Chaz will have a significant lead and very important in this matchup, as it is expected to go on until dampening. So Chaz should return to the fight with basically full mana, but now walking into crowd control from Minpoike. Can Raikou stop the follow-up? Doesn't look like they even bothered to go for it. Silence into potentially Mind Bomb instead. They're going to go for the safe guaranteed route. They don't go for the Mind Bomb. Crowd control chain botched by Change My Mind. They had a bit of an opportunity there to get some big cooldowns like the Glider's Medallion from Waz. And again, Change My Mind, I feel like they're just playing from behind. They aren't getting nearly as sharp crowd control chains as we expect them to. Method Black now looking to get one of their own. I mean, three members in crowd control. None of them can help each other. Acro's taking a ton of damage in game number one. You don't want to lose the swing match advantage. They're patiently holding on to Void Shift. They managed to make it out alive. That was a bold statement to sit through all that crowd control. No trade on cooldowns, but they make it out alive and perhaps on an even footing to push forward to find a kill. Chaz is crowd controlled and Waz is now in trouble.
Yeah, Cloak of Shadows, but he held on to the trinket and I think he's going to be okay. Chaz is able to find some heals, still has the Iron Bark. Just one cooldown. Waz has been doing a really good job staying cool in these situations where he's being targeted down. Goes for the Shadow Step, Kidney Shot over on him in Poike. Vanish, Cheap Shot as well, putting out decent amounts of damage. Actually, the Shadow Mill, Cheap Shot, no longer going to have that available. And could be vulnerable to Maledicts later on. You can see Waz, he's still all over Minpoike. Minpoike having to play catch up. His mana is being taxed heavily. Acro backs him up with a kidney shot, but Raikou in a good position to continue the damage. And a beautiful cyclone coming in from Chaz freezes up Minpoike's HP and or his hit points. And if Waz can land a full stun, Minpoike could definitely be in a situation where he has to trade out his trinket.
Valet knows that Waz wants to stun out of the cyclone, so he used mind control to stop Waz from doing it. And hopefully allow Minpoike to recover. I mean, he's not entirely healthy right now at about 50% health, and he's running balance affinity, so he can't rely on frenzied regeneration to be able to recover in this situation. He needs his team's support, and so far he has managed to stabilize despite that disadvantage. Smoke bomb available for both rogues, but gladiators and medallions available on all six players, so no big power play there for either side. Waz gets engaged on right when he wanted to go after Minpoike, so nice counter engagement by Acro. They drop smoke bomb on this attempt, but again, even with a smoke bomb, all they're getting is a feint, and feint is non-consequential, really, when you commit such a powerful cooldown. Acro has now gone for Vendetta. Waz trades evasion. Fair trade on that part. Mana, surprisingly even, despite the fact that Chaz found a drink and perhaps changed my mind, can win this matchup if they maintain that mana advantage, but I believe that Chaz is sitting down for a drink. Valet is looking to stop it, but he gets intercepted. How much mana did he manage to get? Minpoike is now likely sitting down for a drink. Chaz is essentially full. Minpoike needs to reset his as well if they even want to have a chance here in game number one, but it's looking like he should have. Okay, he didn't. That's unfortunate.
Raku is going to be spamming out damage, still trying to get pressure rolling onto Acro. Chaz has the trinket out of the blind of Acro. Good triple crowd control coming in. Valet gets interrupted. Bash on him, Minpoike. Cheap shot on Acro. This is a great setup coming in from Method Black. Unfortunately, Minpoike was able to dodge that Ring of Frost a little bit late in coming there by Raikou. And as a result, I think Acro is going to be completely fine. And now it's Waz that's in trouble. Cyclone on Chaz. He has to dispel Waz. Does get caught up in that psychic horror from Valet. Dispelling that Vampiric Touch. Now, Kidney Shot over onto Minpoike as they make a swap onto him, trying to keep him guessing in this matchup. That's one thing Method Black has been doing consistently in these games so far, is they're really keeping Change My Mind guessing. They can take down Acro, they can take down Valet, they can take down Minpoike at any moment, and it makes it really difficult to play solid defense for Change My Mind.
Change My Mind, certainly the most improved roster, I would say, globally at this point. Now finally making it to their first Grand Finals. They have a good shot to take out Method Black. They feel confident in this Rogue Shadow Priest Druid, although we at the desk do not. Perhaps they can pull off a victory, pull off a miracle, and take out Method Black and take dominance in the European region and show their rise to power here today. They have that opportunity, but they could potentially be throwing it away based on their composition picks. They seem to be reluctant to go into the mirror, perhaps a lack of confidence. We'll have to find out later in the series if they decide to make that decision. Should they not be able to find victory, they're holding out. They barely got any mana left. It's now close to 20% dampening, reducing the healing in the match by close to 20% at this point in time. Chaz's ability to be able to sneak away from the fight and drink is the main reason why Method Black at this point have such a big advantage.
Yep, definitely going to be having an advantage moving forward. And honestly, every time these teams go head-to-head with these two compositions, they seem to have a massive lead, and that's why we're just so puzzled by Change My Mind. They haven't really been changing too much up in this particular matchup. Now going after Raikou, maybe a bit of a strategy change here, but I don't think at any point they were able to even force out a single ice block when we saw the last time these two teams met up. So I don't know if that's the strategy change they really need. I don't know what they're trying to improve or differ in this matchup. Maybe now in dampening, Raikou becomes a vulnerable target, but it's still Valet that's on the back foot. It's dispersion. It's going to be forced out. Minpoike is almost completely tapped on mana. He's going for crowd control on Chaz. And as a result, I mean, they're getting pressure onto Raikou, but Minpoike's expended a lot of his mana using those cyclones, not really having an opportunity to drink. Raikou goes into an ice block, and maybe this is the point in the game where things snowball out of control and Raikou can actually be taken down after they get through the two ice blocks, but I'm still not convinced.
You know, I've changed my mind, managed to win here. What comp do Method Black play? Is it just the same? They just go for this? Maybe it's a 50-50. Is that their best odds, or is there actually a different comp that they could run? Good crowd control combo here with Raikou and Chaz both casting at the same time, and Poike just can't avoid it, opting to go for being hibernated over polymorphed so that he can't be polymorphed further into the future. Valet, though, in a lot of trouble. He's completely isolated. Once again, out of line of sight of a void shift, potentially. Would he want to use it on Minpoike? I feel like he would prefer to use it on Minpoike so he can break crowd control.
Ooh.
But Minpoike is now stunned. Once again, Waz making the mid-game adaptation, switching his stun, which is normally used on the target he's attacking, instead used on the healer to deny healing right towards potentially the end of the match. Lay is still such low on health, but he wants to push forward. His team has secured crowd control. They have a window of opportunity to get the last ice block, but they have to do it with a sliver of health remaining. They're pushing for it. Can they push far enough to get it? Iron Bark activates. It needs to be enough. Raikou holding out with that as his defense and now looking to counterattack both Belay and Raikou at such low health and making very big power plays. And Poike Cyclone, Akros Poly, Belay's in a 3-on-1, trades out Fade to immune incoming attacks and survival as Healer and Rogue are crowd controlled and unable to assist. Both teams survive the assault and it looks like both teams are kind of pulling away. Raikou waiting for Akro, who is now opened onto him. Smoke bomb play. Chaz jumps in. He can now easily heal Raikou. Good response, although nice getting interrupted. Done. Akro once again setting up the team for victory, but Minpoike needs to get him out of the polymorph. He's not in line of sight. Akro's being left in a lot of crowd control, which means that Raikou can build up a ton of pressure. Now Frost Nova on Akro. Minpoike does manage to finally dispel Akro out and allow him to reconnect. And as he reconnects, Chaz is forced to Iron Bark. This is coming down to the wire. I mean, Change My Mind still have a good shot.
Yep, kidney shot on Raikou. This is definitely the best game we've seen out of Change My Mind. 36% dampening. The offensive dispel coming in from
Beautiful
Balea
kick.
Is really strong. Akro once again making plays. Kick onto Chaz. Raikou could be in some trouble, but keep in mind, if Raikou decides to just use Shimmer to blink away, there's no opportunity for Akro to really reconnect. He doesn't have the cooldowns he needs if he just gets snared up. Raikou just spamming Frostbolts into that Cyclone, trying to connect a snare, trying to just build some damage for his team. This is an opportunity here for Method Black to go after Akro if they really want to. Minpoike completely tapped on mana. Keep in mind, although there's been good damage onto Raikou, he still has an Ice Block. Chaz has a mana lead. Akro could just fall easily. There's a Cyclone on him in Poike. Valet gets locked out. Void Shift comes in, but now they don't have that safety net to fall back on. I just don't know if Akro's ever going to recover, and he doesn't. Method Black in the grand finals up 1-0 against Change.
There was a time where we saw Rogue Mage finals in the European tournaments time and time again, and finally we are back at that here today. Method Black going to be going up against Change My Mind. Change My Mind on a tear, and they can finally have the opportunity to show off the Rogue Mage Druid, which they exclusively played for almost the entirety of the spring season. Ooh. They now have an opportunity to go against Method Black and assert dominance. Are they, in fact, the greatest Rogue Mage?
Ooh, Waz gets a sap on Minpoike. What is the strategy? It looks like full Kidney Shot's going to be used. Frozen Orb, they're going all in on Minpoike. Akro trying to deny, gets the Kidney Shot into a Polymorph onto Waz. And Minpoike, I think, should be able to survive. Bash coming in. Are they going to be able to get the Ring of Frost? They do manage to find it. Now, who's the target of choice for Change My Mind in this matchup? They haven't got any damage rolling whatsoever. They did manage to find a full Ring of Frost on Chaz, but there's just no damage. Raikou's been doing a great job with control. Minpoike is just being trained down in the matchup so far. Finally, they get off him. They get the Iron Bark available, now making a swap over onto Akro. Good offense here from Method Black.
Yeah, Waz really mixing it up, trying to separate Minpoike from Akro by attacking Minpoike early on and then smoke bombing Akro when they're separated and far apart, and that gets them evasion. Big cooldown forced from Akro. Cooldown wise, I would say Change My Mind are behind, but they're going for the more standard strategy of attacking the mage. So Raikou is having a really difficult time doing anything right now. He's isolated. This could be an ice block if they can push forward. Raikou's out of line of sight. Akro wants to connect. He is finally able to with the shadow step. Perfect stun lock. Can they get it? They got 8 more seconds. They drop the smoke one, but then they cyclone him at the same time. They can at least switch the cyclone, but Akro didn't look like he was really ready. He was out of position, but Ursul's Vortex pulls Raikou right back to Akro. They need to get a block on this push. They need to get a block on this push, and they do it. They get the first block. Akro blinded by Waz. Waz was desperately trying to hold on to the ice block, but now Chaz's polymorph. Big mistakes on the side of Method Black. Perhaps just the end of the game here. Game number 2 on Tolvaron. Fried Kitty is low, but he's going for the kill. They've got a window. 28 more seconds to that Iron Bark. They cyclone Raikou beautifully at low health. Change My Mind playing the standard strategy on the mage and really owning right now.
Yeah, Minpoike has been doing a phenomenal job in this game so far with his cyclones, really carrying his team, creating lots of windows of opportunity. But it looks like Raikou does fully recover. Kidney Shot coming in from Akro. Unfortunately, I think it was on diminishing return. So a bit of a mistake there by Akro. It's going to be a limited stun on Raikou, which allows him to get freed up. Those stuns are just so important for the Rogue. It locks down your target and allows you to get off a lot of significant damage. We can see now Akro still just being targeted down. Frozen Orb gets dropped out. Method Black looking to strike back on Akro. They're behind in the mage race. Can they just take down the Rogue? There's no evasion. There's no Cloak of Shadows. There's no Trinket. Akro is actually such a great target right now.
Beautiful pre-Iron Bark on the blind. Chaz anticipated that because he did not have Glyre's Medallion, but he's still crowd. It may not even matter. I mean, Raikou is taking a beating right now. The standard strategy is looking a lot more effective in the Rogue Mage mirror. Method Black spent a lot of time fooling around, and it's costing them a lot of cooldowns. Two ice blocks out of the way, although still one out of the way for Fried Kitty. Method Black, if they can make a good push, could tie it up.
Yeah, I mean, Fried Kitty now still has an advantage. We look at mana, though, and Poike, like I said, he's been going absolutely insane with those Cyclones. He's behind on mana, but it might not matter. And Poike gets locked out. Raikou's the one that's in trouble. Waz trying to do everything he can. You can see Acro in a full Polymorph. Cyclone on Poike. Fried Kitty in a Kidney Shot. Method Black doing an excellent job reversing the pressure. They get the interrupt on Fried Kitty. He's trying to get out of Polymorph, but I don't think he's going to be able to do it. Chaz in a really good position right now with that Balance Affinity. Chaz now into a Cheap Shot, into a full Polymorph. This is the game-winning setup for Change My Mind. Is Raikou going to be able to hold on?
Vinpoike is star surging, looking for Cyclone, gets shut down. Perfect shutdown by Raikou. If they had continued that crowd control, there was nothing left for Raikou to stay alive. So Raikou keeping himself in the fight with a perfectly timed counterspell. Vinpoike looks like he needs to drink, and Chaz is not going to let him. Looking for Hibernate, looking for Ring at the same time. Perfect crowd control casting by Raikou and Chaz. This now has isolated Fried Kitty. This has given Method Black an opportunity to even out the ice blocks. They need to continue the chain, but they've stopped Chaz with counterspell, so they drop Smoke Bomb to make sure they get the second ice block. Method Black keep themselves in the game.
Yep, it's a tie ball game. Fried Kitty still low. Are they going to be able to get anything going? Raikou does use both of his shimmers. If Acro can reconnect, it's going to be big. There's a full Cyclone onto Waz, or onto Chaz. And now Raikou's vulnerable. He's in a full Kidney Shot and a Smoke Bomb. Does Fried Kitty have any damage? Unfortunately, he's in a Kidney Shot himself.
Well done.
Waz still trying to do the best he can. There's a Cyclone onto Chaz. Then you can see Waz, he's trying to peel up Minpoike to prevent any of the incoming crowd control. Raikou does manage to barely hold on off the back of that Iron Bark, but a nice Cyclone once again comes in from Minpoike. Now, Change My Mind, if they can get crowd control on Chaz, they find the sap.
Ooh, Chaz wrapping around the corner, dipping out of combat, getting sapped and having to trinket it. This means when he gets blinded, it's game over. It may just be game over right now. The damage of Change My Mind is insane. Why did they not just go for the mirror 4 games ago? There's the blind. This has to be the end of the game. Waz and Raikou have to carry while Chaz is crowd controlled. Somehow, the pressure is not high. This is not the amount of damage I anticipated with the blind. Raikou should easily be dead. They still continue it, but they have not used Polymorph Diminishing Return. They did not get a sap. Perhaps Acro should have waited to go for the blind play. Raikou holds out. Now Minpoike is crowd controlled. Fried Kitty doesn't have any ice blocks. Both mages in a lot of trouble. Raikou stunned up. Chaz has Iron Bark available. Is going to commit it and stabilize him in this position. Vendetta for Acro. No Iron Bark for Chaz, no ice blocks for Raikou for at least another minute, so Acro still has an opportunity to win this. Waz setting up a Shadow Step kick. Acro looking like he wants to make a play. How are they going to set this up? Fried Kitty, he's scared. He's trying to run away. Raikou is just teeing off this point with lots of Frost Bolts. Fried Kitty looking to reverse the pressure. Kidney Shot. Raikou Trinkets blinks back defensively. Acro in hot pursuit. Vendetta is rolling. This is a lot of damage. Ooh. Acro's looking to win the game for the team. Setting up the Cheap Shot. Fried Kitty moves in. He needs to get it. He gets the Polymorph. Once again, Raikou and Waz have to carry Chaz, but Waz is Frost Nova midfield. Raikou is polymorphing Acro to just stay alive. They drop the chain. Chaz is out of crowd control. He has Iron Bark. He should be able to stabilize. Once again, Raikou, Live Lord.
Yeah, great job by Raikou. A lot of moments, but now it's Fried Kitty who's in trouble. Minpoike, he's got no trinket. He throws out the Iron Bark to keep Fried Kitty alive. He's trying to kite away, trying to maneuver. Gets crowd control onto Waz to stabilize. Is there going to be a full Ring of Frost onto Chaz? No, Growth Silence coming in from Waz. That shuts down the crowd control. Fried Kitty, unfortunately, not able to find the crowd control that they need. And now Raikou, I think he's bought himself enough time. He's in a Kidney Shot right now, but he's got 5 seconds left on Cold Snap. Are they going to be able to take him down for a Cold Snap? 1 second left in the Cheap Shot. They don't have the damage. Is Raikou going to hold on? He's going to greet it. Go for the double ice block. Interrupt over onto Chaz. This could cost Raikou the game. Is he going to be able to hold on? Does manage to buy himself enough time. And now it's Fried Kitty on the back foot. He still doesn't have his ice block for another 56 seconds. Minpoike completely out of mana. Chaz in the blind gets uses a trinket to stay alive in the fight to keep the aggression going.
You have to kill Waz and Smoke Bomb. You don't have a choice. You've got no time left. There's 2 ice blocks for Raikou. He pops Icy Veins. Fried Kitty, there's no way you should make it out alive. If Raikou even gets 1 flurry, Fried Kitty is going to explode. Chaz is getting perfect Cyclones chained together. Polymorph out of it. Beautifully done by Method Black. They've managed to pull it back together off of Raikou's perfect defensive play. And Fried Kitty's looking like he is going to fall. How on earth is he still alive at this point?
He's
holding
not.
On, but ultimately falling. Method Black continue their lead 2-0.
Heartbreaking.
My mind were running. Curious to see if there is any shenanigans, if we see any druid rushdowns, as that has been done in the past between Rogue Mage Mirrors. Raikou and Fried Kitty are just going into center field and casting frost bolts on each other. They're going to be generating icicles, which deal a ton of burst damage. Fried Kitty actually just tossing his out immediately onto Raikou. A little bit of a bold statement. The 1v1 in the middle continues, whereas Raikou holds on to his icicles, which makes me wonder, who is he actually going to be attacking? Maybe it isn't Fried Kitty.
Yeah, it looks like Waz, he got sapped into a Frost Nova. He has to use his Vanish. He wants to play a little bit of defense here for Raikou, as that would have been a disastrous opener. Now getting aggressive. Nicely done by Waz. I really like just using the Vanish, turning this opener on its head. Changed my mind now on the back foot. Minpoike into a Cyclone. Is he going to manage to find any follow-up crowd control? Minpoike didn't actually get put in crowd control, and they still managed to get that first ice block. I don't know what kind of burst damage they had available, but that might have been too early of an ice block, but Fried Kitty does manage to hold on, and at least they didn't overlap it with that precious iron bark from Minpoike.
Yep, definitely good that they didn't overlap, but Minpoike continues to get crowd controlled. Method Black looking like they're solid to push for second ice block and potentially the third game and put Change My Mind on match point. But as I say that, Fried Kitty secures crowd control on Chaz, and Raikou is once again on the run. Can Raikou hold out long enough? Three members of the team crowd controlled. He can't. He is forced to ice block. Now we are even on ice blocks between the two teams. And even though they had the edge early on, that is going to be a breath for Change My Mind to potentially take a game here and maybe have a comeback in the series.
Yeah, Waz, nice peels. Cheap shot on Acro. Full kitty shot over onto Fried Kitty. And you can see Minpoike, he's caught into a cheap or a polymorph as well, into a full cycle. And this could easily be the second ice block. Acro looking to turn around the pressure with the full kitty shot on Raikou. He's got no trinket. He has to sit at full. Chaz runs into the smoke bomb, gets the iron bark, and that should be enough to keep him alive. And now it's Fried Kitty that's in trouble. Minpoike still just holding on to that iron bark, saving it for a rainy day. But he has the healing he needs to keep Fried Kitty alive. Finally, a full kitty shot gets committed over from Waz onto Fried Kitty, and a cyclone actually follows that up from Chaz. Nicely done, and now Fried Kitty is not going to be able to get topped off. It's going to slow down some of this offense, and unfortunately, Acro, he commits the full kidney shot, but Fried Kitty was in a cyclone. Now Acro's in a full cyclone. Chaz single-handedly completely shut down that attempt on Raikou.
All right, let's see who gets to do the first attack. Waz initiates with a stun. Chaz gets follow-up. Raikou blocks out Fried Kitty. They're making a swap to Acro, looking to kill him in a bursty fashion, but unable to do so. Minpoike denies the kill. As a black, once again, showing that they are willing to mix it up and go on different targets, whereas Change My Mind have solely committed their attacks to Raikou throughout.
Yeah, man, I mean, in the first game, they were ahead. They managed to get both of Raikou's ice blocks, but ultimately it was Fried Kitty that fell after some nice clean setups coming in from Method Black in this matchup. Raikou has actually still not used his cold snap, so this is... it's a risky play for Raikou. If they do manage to force him to use that cold snap, use that ice block, he's going to be so far behind on that third ice block.
Oh, big spot!
Off, they're going to need it. Minpoike caught into the kidney shot, caught into the bash, manages to escape with his life for now. And I think he's going to be able to stabilize his health, but that was a really beautiful attempt there by Method Black. And now Minpoike is in a very dangerous situation. He's got no bar skin. He's got no trinket. He's in a full blind. Fried Kitty into a full kidney shot. Method Black all over the place, styling on Change My Mind at this point. And Fried Kitty is just so far behind on ice blocks.
Method Black are just continuing to play on their toes, and Change My Mind cannot keep up with the constant swaps, the constant switch-ups that Method Black are throwing their way. And I mean, I can confidently say that I think Method Black could take this 4-0 if they can keep this up. Change My Mind finally changing up their strategies, trying to go after Chaz. Chaz sees it coming. He's already in bear form. He takes basically zero damage as a result of that predicted attack. So now they go for blind instead. They do at least bank his glider's medallion, but they're behind on one ice block. Raikou has cold snap and potentially two if he can hold out for another minute. Icy Veins is rolling. He's got frozen orb. This could be a big attack. Smoke bomb available as well. Waz could just close the game out. Minpoike is crowd controlled. Acro can't support. If Waz connects, surely Fried Kitty will go down. Minpoike doing everything he can. Casting Cyclone, looking to try and stall it out. Waz knows that they've got the game in the bag if they can connect with this next big hit. So he uses Cloak of Shadows to stay on target. Kidney shot, Shadow Step kick. Beautiful setup. But Acro looks to punish Waz for that aggressive stance on Cloak of Shadows, potentially switching, but Fried Kitty not able to support with too much damage just yet. Minpoike continues with follow-up crowd control, potentially an overextension of Waz, definitely being abused right now by Change My Mind.
Yeah, Waz a little bit low, has to drop out a defensive smoke bomb to avoid some damage coming from Fried Kitty. He has the icy veins. He's been able to put out a lot of pressure in the matchup. Full Ring of Frost onto Chaz. He got the Iron Bark preemptively, though, onto Waz, who's now into a stun. Acro looking to close out the game. Can he take down Waz? He's almost got his trinket. Evasion's rolling up. He has Vendetta. Waz could reverse the pressure onto Fried Kitty, who still has no Ice Blush for another 45 seconds. This could be the setup that they need. Kidney Shot, Kleptomania. Waz still reluctant to use the Vendetta. It looks like Chaz is just going to be using the Cyclone to freeze up Fried Kitty's health for now.
Yep, freeze it up for now. Mana, though, could be the name of the game. How well is Chaz doing? Not too well, actually. Changed my mind with a bit of a lead there, but Ice Blocks, two for Raikou, none for around 20 seconds for Fried Kitty. Although Waz could be an option. I'm curious if changed my mind, mix it up here. Method Black has been mixing it up throughout and really catching changed my mind off guard. It looks like they do want to target down Waz. Chaz cannot heal in Cyclone, but Acro is the one actually in trouble. Waz is trying to make a decision whether or not to go aggressive. He does get caught in midfield, stunned up, but Chaz is there, ready and waiting with that Iron Bark. So they Cyclone Waz instead, waiting for Iron Bark's defense to fall, then looking to make a move later on. I mean, at this point, do you abandon trying to kill the mage if you know that Raikou has two Ice Blocks? Like, do you have to go after the rogue? It sort of feels like you do at this point.
Well, the thing is, when you're on the rogue, you lose a lot of that control over the mage. And these setups, these opportunities that Method Black is finding on him in Poike could be very dangerous. Kidney Shot into Bash. Do they have the damage? Minpoike trying to escape, but the Garrote Silence from Waz will freeze any of his healing for now. He manages to find another one. Can Waz take him down? Raikou needs to get in line of sight, but unfortunately, he's just caught into a Polymorph. Minpoike dodges around everybody, finding the full Bash into Polymorph onto Chaz. Nicely done by Minpoike, turning that situation around. And now it's changed my mind that has pressure onto Waz. And you can see Waz, no Cloak of Shadows, no Evasion, no Trinket. He's a prime target here for changed my mind. But Minpoike once again getting swapped to. This is a scary situation.
I mean, it's a race at this point. Kill Waz before he kills Minpoike, because Waz is just going to go all out.
Uh-oh.
Acro supports. He stuns Waz. Chaz saves him. Minpoike is still low. Raikou gets stunned. Raikou just wants to finish this, but he needs to get control and allow Waz to stay on target. So he's polymorphing Acro. Minpoike gets cloned at low health. Waz, though, goes for the stun on Acro instead. A bit surprised to not see them try and just kill Minpoike and finish the game. But this game has shifted gears. It's no longer a mage race. It seems to be a swap to the healer or tunnel down the rogue. It's interesting how this strategy has adapted throughout the entire series between both teams. Neither druid really has any mana remaining. Dampening is going up. Minpoike is trying to drink. His team does have defense to trade. Chaz is trying to stop it. Chaz jumps over, but he jumps into a stun. Minpoike can engage crowd control. There's no interrupt. He's cycloned. Waz could be in trouble. There's no evasion, but he's actually just going for the kill. He knows Minpoike doesn't have mana. Maybe he can just power through with pressure, and it's looking dicey. Minpoike gets caught. He's polymorphed. Acro in a bit of trouble. He interrupts Cyclone. He's on the run. He's out of line of sight of Raikou. Double Ring of Frost defensively from Fried Kitty is stalling the assault so far, but Minpoike is still crowd controlled. He does not want to have to trinket. They drop the smoke bomb. They go for a big power play on Waz. Raikou blinks into the bomb, but gets interrupted on the peel. Waz is still low, but Chaz manages to make it in and get the Iron Bark, which is keeping Waz alive at this moment in time.
That was a really nice play there by Acro. I'm not sure it's going to end up mattering, but good teamwork between Fried Kitty and Acro, baiting Waz to move in, and they managed to get a good opener on him. And that might actually close out the game. Chaz still into a polymorph. Waz has to play evasive right now, and Acro's the one that's getting hit. Raikou doing a lot of damage. Waz has to trink out of the kidney shot. Is he going to be able to reverse the pressure over onto Acro? Waz trades out the evasion. Cloak of Shadows, basically his entire defensive arsenal to survive the setup, but Chaz, he's still in a blind. The crowd control's not over. Waz forced to use blind on Acro defensively, and things are spiraling out of control here for Method Black.
Things are spiraling out of control, but he could blind sap, kidney shot Acro, pop Vendetta, and 100-0 the rogue if they can crowd control Minpoike at the same time. Waz is polymorph. Both teams are just stalling right now, waiting to find a target. Very surprising to see Fried Kitty as the target. I mean, I guess they might just get an ice block off of it, but Acro is far more vulnerable. They get Iron Bark. Perhaps they switch targets if they go after Acro with Vendetta. It looks like they're actually pressuring Chaz a bit. Fried Kitty is just attacking Chaz almost randomly, but it could open an opportunity to kill him in a stun. both teams, I mean, at this point, it's absolutely insane. And Poike gets sapped when he's trying to drink. Acro is in a lot of trouble. Fortunately, he saw the attack coming and activated Faint. It reduced a lot of damage during the stun. And Poike now breaks out of crowd control. Acro looks to reverse the pressure. He's got a sliver of health. Raikou is just trying to finish him. Waz could be in trouble, but manages to survive. Vendetta is still rolling. Acro is so low. And Poike has nothing for 10 more seconds. Acro is looking like he's going to be going down. Method Black in the driver's seat. Acro barely holding on. Stun connects. He decides to tap out. We don't very often see a player on their statistics chart. It feels like they haven't played it in forever. And then they're just trouncing here in the finals against Change My Mind. And they've got the Rogue Mages, they've got the melee cleaves, they've got the Spellcaster cleaves. Method Black looks like a team that could just take the entire globe.
I mean, they've always kind of looked that way, to be fair. I mean, for a while now, they've been really well adapted, especially since Swapsy has been in. I think the main problem they have is sometimes they just have so many options, they don't know exactly what they should be picking. But in this particular matchup, it's obvious they want to play that Rogue Mage Druid, and I think anytime they can play that, they're happy to do so. And you can bet Swapsy's probably sitting on the sidelines cheering his team on, really happy that they're taking on such a great team like Change My Mind in a mirror match.
All right, let's see if they can do it. And Poike is crowd controlled early on. Method Black have always made it so tricky to decide who are they actually going to attack, and it throws teams for a loop, especially Change My Mind, whereas Change My Mind, they're slowly but surely edging their way into sort of mixing it up as well. And if we get to the point where Change My Mind are making swaps, switching targets frequently, such as Method Black is doing, then this could reverse sweep. This could go all the way to a game number seven. But right now, Acro's in a lot of trouble. Smoke Bomb is preventing Minpoike from healing him. Multiple Gladiators Maledicts incoming. Acro isn't receiving healing as Minpoike is cycloned, but Iron Bark activated before the crowd control is stabilizing him. Cycloned at low health by Chaz. What's Minpoike going to do while his rogue is cycloned at low health? Waz looks to try and set up. He gets a re-stealth, goes for the cheap shot. That sets up for crowd control, but they don't get the follow-up. He gets disrupted by Acro. Beautiful interrupt. Minpoike still needs to dodge polymorphs. He's max ranging away from Raikou. Does not want to get caught off guard by one of those, but Chaz is now in position to cycle him. Minpoike wild charges out of range of it. Chaz looks like he wants to re-stealth and maybe go for a stun into Cyclone, but the longer he stays in cat form like this, he's not healing healing Raikou or Waz. Chaz now giving up that in a kidney shot.
Ooh, nice bear form.
Are they going to switch targets? It looks like they are going to try and switch targets to Chaz and kill him through Barkskin and bear form. It seems unlikely that they will be able to do. Chaz, once again, reading the situation well.
Yeah, that was excellently done. I mean, that's the first time we've seen in this series they really go after Chaz. So the fact that he had the heads-up play to be in bear form, avoid a lot of that damage, speaks volume to what a phenomenal player he really is. Full blind now secured on him in Poike, but who is their target? Who are they going after? What are they trying to accomplish with this blind? Poike gets caught into a ring of frost. He's deciding to trinket out of that immediately as Frog Kitty was caught into a kidney shot, but they overlap their trinkets. Now the next time we see Minpoike in crowd control, Frog Kitty could be in some trouble, but changed my mind. They're going after Chaz. He's got no Barkskin. He's got no trinket. Forced to use his Iron Bark, but he's still in trouble. Ray of Frost being channeled. Chaz finally gets out of line of sight, avoiding damage. See Waz trying to back him up just a little bit. Acro lands a cheap shot onto Waz into a kidney shot. Are they going to be able to find any sort of significant damage? It doesn't look like it just yet, but you can see Method Black, they're actually behind in terms of mana.
I mean, they're behind in terms of everything at this point. Change My Mind are finally getting some momentum here, looking like they're at least going to be able to put a point on the board. Smoke Bomb gets dropped from Acro. He's trying to set up a kill on Waz and also prevent Waz's pressure with this Vendetta currently activated. So a bit of a two for one on that Smoke Bomb. Even though they don't get the kill, they stall a kill attempt by Waz.
Ooh.
Now they mix it up. They go after Chaz again. They get his Glider's Medallion. Now blind is a potential win condition moving forward as Waz is limited in his defense at this current moment in time. Change My Mind have the mana lead. They have the cooldown lead respectively as well, and perhaps can swing this back if they keep it up. But now Method Black once again go for an attack on Minpoike. He saw it coming. He activated Iron Bark on himself, but is it really going to be it's match point. The first cup on the line here as Minpoike is being pressured incredibly hard and will fall to the swap. Method Black mixing it up time and time again.
Yeah, it goes from a 60-point gap to a 100-point gap now between Wildcard Gaming and Method Black. And bear in mind, Method Black have come in the top two of all seven cups so far.
Feed versus the fake Zebras, we're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for